In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can conditionally format the results of your lookup formula inside your data table. So we're going to be taking a look at two things. One is that we're going to have a quick look at my favorite formula, which is index and match. But most importantly, we're going to see how we can highlight the result of the index and match inside the actual data set. So for example, if I select Perino from this list, and I select the month from here, then not only do I see the result in the cell here, but I also see it marked differently inside the data set. As a first step, I'm gonna add a dropdown for the apps and a dropdown for the months. So let's do it here. We're gonna go to data, data validation, select list, and for the apps, I'm gonna highlight this. And say okay. So here I get my apps. Right here, I want to go back to data validation and add one for my months. Okay, so I'm just going to highlight them in a different color. And now what I want is two things. One is to get the result right here. And second is to mark that result in this range here so that I can visually immediately see, okay, that's my number, that's my match. First off, let's get the result. I'm going to use my favorite formula, which is index and match. I explained this in more detail in a separate video, so I'm going to go through it rather quickly here because the aim of this video is to show how we do that conditional formatting part. But quickly, the first argument in index is my array. That's basically the area where my answer is. So basically the map of my answer. Now, I don't need to do any fixing because I'm not planning to pull this formula down. So that's my map. Then how many rows do I need to move within that map to get to my answer? Now, the first thing that comes to mind is which one of these are on the rows? It's this one, right? So I have to match for this in here and see which position it's on. And the match function is great because it's going to return the position of this app. So that's my lookup value in here. And I want an exact match. Okay, so in this case, that should return 2. So it tells index, index this area, move 2 rows down. Now I also need to tell it how many columns to move, and that's going to depend on my month. And that's where it should look it up. And I do want an exact match and close brackets. In this case, it's Feb, so move 2 columns, which means I'm indexing this area. I'm going 2 down, 1, 2, 2 columns, 1. I'm counting the first column and 2 here. So my answer should be 603. Now, how do I mark this in here? First of all, which functionality do I use to mark it? Conditional formatting, right? Because that's going to help me format that whole cell differently based on a condition. Now, the first time I took a look at this, I thought of it the wrong way. I was thinking, how do I find this number in here? So I was thinking, well, then do I use index and match inside my conditional formatting formula? But then I realized I can't really do that because I can have 2 numbers that are identical, right? So if I would select Perino and I select March, I have 802, but I also have 802 here. And then I thought, well, I need to double check also if I have the right column and I have the right row. And then I thought, well, actually, I don't need to worry about the number at all. I just need to think about the right column and the right row, and that's going to give me my match. But then the tricky part is the use of conditional formatting. If I just go here and go to new rule, in this case, we need to use a formula to see which cells to format. So that depends on, is the column equal to this, and is the row equal to this app? That means I need to use a formula. But in conditional formatting, it's quite difficult to type in your formulas. First of all, you don't get the Excel help about which arguments to put in. And second of all, you have to be so very careful with your fixing. If I click in a cell in here, by default, it always fully fixes the cell referencing. And that's not always what I need. Because I don't always need to look at this one specific cell. I need it to be dynamic. I could be tempted to take away all the fixing, but that's also sometimes not what I need. And it's always very difficult to assess because you're writing the whole formula from the point of view of the first cell, and then you have to think, how does it apply to the other cells? Now, one thing that I've seen Mike do often is to type the formulas here, because then you actually see what it's doing so that you know that it's working before you copy and paste it in conditional formatting. So I'm going to follow in his footsteps and I'm going to do it in that way as well. Our next challenge is, what formula do we type in here? Okay, we said that we need to check if the column equals to this and this equals to this. That calls for the AND condition because two things have to be true for this to be formatted. Okay, so let's start with that. I'm going to say AND. Now, this equals to this. Now, right here, we come to our next challenge, which is the type of fixing that we use, which is the key to making conditional formatting work properly. So for this one, that's easy. Yes, I can fully fix it. But what about this? I can't fully fix it because it's always going to reference January, right? So I want to be able to copy it this way and down. I want the column to move, but I don't want the row to move. That means I need to fix the row, but not the column. Okay, so that's my first check. Next logical test is this one equal to this. So now this is easy to fix. I need to fix everything. The A7, how do I fix this? The A or the 7? Well, I want, when I pull this down to apply to this data, to move down. So that number 7 is going to be changed. But I don't want A to change. I don't want it to jump into my data. So I just need to fix the column here. Okay, so if both of these occur. Now, if I press enter, I get false because none of these are actually equal. So I'm going to pull this across and pull it all the way down. So I see all false, but I need to have one true in there, and that's this one, right? That's the 802, and it's the correct 802. It's the one for March and Perino. So it looks like my formula is right. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to go to conditional formatting, but before I go there, I'm going to mark the area that I want conditionally formatted. Now let's go here, click on new rule, use a formula, and let's paste this formula in there with the correct fixing of our cell references. So let's go to format. Let's choose a nice fill color. We can also add a border to it. Okay, and that's our match. So let's double check. Let's go to Fighter and May. Okay, looks great. You can see our true false is changing here. And once we're done, we can remove this part. That's how you can conditionally format your range to find your matched results based on the lookup parameters that you define here. As always, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And for more videos like this one, why not subscribe to this channel so that you can get updates when new videos come out.